Hi, everybody. I'm Crandall.
I'm Mercy.
We are Armchair Directors.
Based on the best-selling novel.
We are here. We are back. First off, we are back.
We're back. We have to say it about 10 times. We're back.
Yeah, so many times that we have to remind people we're back. So we're taking a look at The Maze Runner, the first installment based on another popular young adult trilogy.
Yeah, so since it's a trilogy, that probably means it's going to be four or five movies, because it's just standard to split the last movie at least into two movies, right?
And of course, the rub with these kind of movies is when they make them, they never know if they're going to make enough money to actually justify ever making the additional movies. Now, yep. Maze Runner 2, The Scorched Trials, has already been greenlit, so we know that this story is going to continue. But that's sort of the problem with these movies, is that when you watch them, they're not bad. Yeah. But half the time they feel like part of a movie, because you don't get a full story, because they're trying to push you along into the next chapter that might never get made.
Right. That's what I thought going into this. I'm just going to do a sidestep here before I forget. We're really bad at bringing up news, Armchair Directors news. Mm-hmm. In the opening of these intros, we just like to go for it and start talking about the movie. And I will in a couple seconds, but I just wanted to say thank you to everyone who's ever viewed one of our videos on YouTube. We just hit a huge milestone, 1 million views in total.
Wow.
On YouTube. But you didn't know about this, Matt?
I did. I did. I was feigning surprise.
how many hundreds of thousands of views were you? Because I know about half was probably me.
Oh, yeah.
No, but I just wanted to take a second to thank everybody. I never thought I'd be able to get a million people, or it's not a million people, but I never thought I'd get people to do a million of anything in my life. So scratch that off the bucket list. That's a really cool milestone.
Yeah, and, thanks, guys.
And really appreciate it, and looking forward to hitting 2 million. So back to The Maze Runner, going into it. Yeah, I was a little apprehensive, thinking, okay, here we go. We're going to get that partial story. But to jump to the very end, actually, I walked out of this movie pretty satisfied. I felt like I got a beginning, middle, end, which I'm always harping about in these reviews, even when we're going to see an installment in a saga. So I didn't really feel, maybe because the movie, I liked it, but it wasn't amazing. Maybe because I was ready for it to be done. I wasn't wishing there was more. I was just happy that it was done and I could leave. Not that I hated it, but it was just, after watching so many of these based on a best-selling series, movies, it just kind of felt like more of the same. And I think this movie, it's hard to compare movies to each other a lot of the time, but I think this is a movie that can really be compared to other movies similar to it. So mm-hmm. I think it is comparing apples to apples. When you compare The Maze Runner to The Hunger Games, to Twilight, to Harry Potter. So as far as I'm concerned, and also I Am Number 4, because you mentioned movie series that...
That don't quite take off, yeah. Yeah,
so as far as comparing it to the other series, movies based on novels, I'm going to say that I enjoyed this way more than I Am Number 4.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think it's anywhere near as good as Hunger Games. No. So if you're expecting something like Hunger Games, it's not even Hunger Games light. As far as being as good as Twilight, I'm going to say the acting is better than Twilight. Mm-hmm. But it's just so simple that you might be a little bored watching this thing.
Yeah. And there were times that watching it, We do get, you know, sort of like a full story of beginning, middle, and end. But so much of the time, they have to give us these long, drawn-out exposition scenes to explain what it is we've just seen that we might as well be reading a book sometimes. Mm. Like the end, it's like, okay, what does any of this mean? Well, guess what? Here's Patricia Clarkson to explain what the last 2 hours has meant. And we're just going to give you 5 minutes of telling you why this had to happen.
Yeah.
But sometimes you're just like, well, still, I don't understand why any of this had to happen for what they just sort of explained to us. It felt to me, they're aiming this at, you know, the teens, but this is kind of like Saw for teens.
Yeah, it is a little
Right, like, you
grizzly,
know,
yeah.
well, and not even grisly, but like, you know, there's this, it's like the game that they've set up, and they don't care who lives or dies. They want to see how people react to these traps and twists and turns, which is basically they're like the jigsaw putting these people into this saw-like thing just to see what will happen, and if people die, then who cares? And there were parts of this movie that I felt like, you know, were kind of like those older Saw movies where it's just grisly stuff happening for the sake of having some grisly stuff happen. Now it's not bloody, but it's just, you know, a bunch of kids get taken by these monsters and supposedly murdered and stuff. So it was pretty dark.
Yeah, also there's some Lord of the Flies in here as well.
Oh yeah,
Where
Lord of the
you're
Flies Battle Royale.
it's so if you're cool with just watching a bunch of, they're not all kids, they're not like little kids. It never feels like Thunderdome. So
Right.
chill. It's not going to be like the kids in the crack in the earth. But it is kind of it does kind of have that vibe because they're in this little oasis in this very dark and terrifying world and they have
The
their little
Glade.
Yeah, they have their little forest that they live in. Yeah, I saw it a week ago and I'm having some real difficulty remembering anything that happened in it. So it as far as I can remember it, it's a pretty forgettable movie. Not a good sign for your first installment in an epic trilogy or quadrilogy movie series. I gotta say though, the main character, really good actor. He's not as good as Jennifer Lawrence, but how many people are,
Right, yeah,
right?
he was actually surprisingly decent. And there are some thrilling action scenes in this.
Yeah,
So
for
there are
sure.
some cool moments where the maze is moving and they're running through it, and we don't know what's going to happen next. And I did appreciate the action aspect of it, but some of it is just like really drawn out, sort of like Lord of the Flies light, because it doesn't really have that much social commentary on its mind. That, yeah, you watch it and then almost immediately you forget it.
Yeah. All right. Well, that leads into best part.
Worst part.
And my best part, you just mentioned it, the maze running. The
Yeah.
movie's called The Maze Runner. I wanted to see a bunch of people running in a maze. I really like how the main character, it's hilarious that I can't remember his name. What was it?
Thomas.
Thomas. Okay. Right. Well, he couldn't remember his name either.
No, he
So,
couldn't.
but I like how he originally goes into the maze. I thought that was a cool moment. Won't spoil it for you, but it's a little good hero moment. It sets him apart from the other douchebags who just kind of turn tail.
Right.
And this guy kind of steps up and you know, wow, this guy, you know, he's a pretty brave, good classical style hero. So I like the maze running, some real intense moments, edge of your seat stuff. If you're skittish, you're going to be jumping and
Right.
getting freaked out. They don't really rely too much on the cheap scares, but they do it well, man. They're intense, and how often can you say that about movies these days, where you're like, "Oh my God," and the thing t chasing them is ugly as hell.
Yeah.
I mean, it puts the predator to shame. So again, how many times can you say that a monster or a beast in a movie, you'll just look at it and go, "Gosh, darn, that is disgusting."
Yeah, it was basically like a giant spider mixed with a robot mixed with like an orc or something. It was gross.
Yeah, it had a very, for me, very H.R. Giger vibe to it, that biomechanical nightmare.
Yep.
And then the worst part of the movie is the stuff in the glade is pretty boring. They got their little way of life, and then you've got the antagonist in the camp who doesn't want anything to change. And it's just so boring that it's boring and they don't want it to be anything other than boring. And I was just like, oh my God, please something happen. And the problem with my worst part is that even if they go in the maze, like, what does that mean? That I don't know if they're going to die or what are they going to find. I don't even care if they go in the maze. So the one hope of excitement I have is really not all that interesting either.
Right. And I'm gonna go worst part. Yeah, a lot of those scenes at the Glade where the guy Gally is just being a dick for the sake of this movie needed a dick in it, right? Because this new greenie, Thomas, hasn't done anything, but we've got the guy who, you know, wants to punch him in the face and beat him up. And just be the alpha male, like, welcome to the OC, bitch, for no reason. It just felt so stale. And then he makes friends with, the one kid, Chuck, who doesn't really add anything to it, especially the end with that character was just like a why?
Poor Chuck. Why?
So there were a lot of the superfluous characters are exactly that. They just take up time. A bunch of the stuff in the Glade has no consequences and is just really boring because the movie's called The Maze Runner, and until anybody goes in the maze is like 40 minutes.
Yeah.
And I'm like, holy shit, can we just get on with it? But then once they get on with it, it's not bad. So that is my worst part, other than the fact that there is no David Bowie in this.
Oh, how cool would that have been? As the Goblin King.
As the Goblin King just shows up. And then best part, yeah, the action scenes were entertaining. There was some good thrills. I'm intrigued enough that, like, I will go see the second one. So it's not something like I Am Number 4, where even if they made I Am Number 5 or whatever the hell, there was no way I was going to it.
Right.
This one, there was enough there that I'll check out the next one, but it's not like a Hunger Games where I'm really looking forward to it.
And as far as I'm concerned, I'm actually, it's not like I've got to see the next one. And I want to tread lightly here because I don't want to completely spoil the end here because there is a bit of a twist.
Mm-hmm.
But there is a post-apocalyptic world that I imagine they'll be exploring in the next movie.
Yeah.
And I am a fan of that Mad Max desert bombed out destroyed world. Like not just like a Walking Dead post-apocalyptic, but a world that has just been scorched and there's nothing left. So that looks like that might be what the next movie is about, and that will grab my attention.
Yeah, it will be cool to see how they push it forward when we are in a world that's, halfway between Mad Max, The Matrix, and Terminator Salvation sort of stuff. Like I said, I'm intrigued to see where it's going, and I hope that they can build on the successes in this and maybe bring a little bit more visual flair to it so it's not as much exposition to get the point across. Show me some of this stuff rather than just constantly telling me.
Mm-hmm. All right, and we've got a couple of viewer comments. Two, actually. I guess not many people have gone out to see The Maze Runner, but thanks for posting your comments about the movie on our Facebook page. I'm going to start off with Gabriel Green. He said, quite good. The young cast was excellent, and the action scenes were very intense and suspenseful, and I was very interested in the direction. Very interested to see what this new guy does next.
Yeah, so this guy who directed it, Wes Ball, this is one of his first big movies, and I thought he did an okay job.
His name's Wes Ball?
Yeah.
Too bad it's not Wes Balls.
and then the other comment is from Tony Morrow that says the movie would have been a lot better if it featured Hoggle peeing into a fountain, which is pretty much a rule for any movie.
What is he referencing there?
That's Labyrinth.
Oh, okay. Thanks, Tony. And thanks, Gabriel. And thanks, everybody. So that's The Maze Runner. Not a glowing review. Maybe wait for it on Blu-ray, or maybe even wait a few years down the road and just binge watch The Maze Runner saga altogether.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks a lot for listening. And until next time.
Enjoy the show. You remind me of the babe.
What babe?
The babe with the power.